Check that out. Nice video. Welcome to the Rain Village of Taiwan. Do you know Naruto?
Yes.
the one in the video. I mean, it looks a lot like the Rain Village, the one where the Akatsuki group is situated. There's a lot of rain.
Well, yeah.
But you can see how heavy the work has been done on that hype video, conceptualizing those popular places
for
the participating countries here at LICC and converting that to League team, builds of justice team places. Like, for example, I love the way how they change our Rizal Park monument into like a Nexus-like design.
The Rizal was the Nexus itself.
Yes. So, guys, welcome back for the LICC LOL International Collegiate Championships 2016. This is day 2, and we are now onto our game 5. Game 5, right?
Yes,
we are now on our game 5, and we're going to be your shoutcasters for this match. I am Shinbu with a 1-4, and I, and with me is, of course, Alpha. Ladies and gentlemen, what are we about to witness is the match of our, this Philippine representative, once again, TIP, right?
No, I think that's the game 6. So UPH, that's UPH versus IVE.
Game 5, game 6. So we still have game 6 for our Philippine representative. I'm sorry, I'm very excited.
Yes,
to,
I know.
To follow the journey of our Philippine representative. But let's go, let's get into the drafting phase, as what we have will be the match between UPH of Indonesia versus IVE. So, ladies and gentlemen, discussing the bans here. They have the Jace, they have the Syndra, they could ban the Jin, they could ban the Olaf, they could ban the Kenneth. Those are the popular bans coming in from the worlds. But interestingly, one ban that hails from this match is the Zillion.
Yes,
the Zillion
of course.
Ban on the side of IVE. So,
I think it was the Zillion that has been picked up by the bombs from TIP. Like the double kill manifestation.
I'd say even though UPH doesn't have that much of us, still have a kind of a shaky start.
Yes.
In this group stage, I think they are running with two defeats already in this league. There's this respect match still.
Yes, of
course. On Thompson's Zillion. Actually, Thompson is one player to watch out against for the side of
UPH.
UPH. So, all the more reason that you want to ban a Zillion, let's just disable Thompson, put him on a more uncomfortable position, removing his
chances. Also did ban that Victor away from Thompson. So, there's a possibility that they are really respecting this guy from UPH.
Yes.
So, and of course, on the bans coming from UPH, that's a Jace, Syndra, and Olaf. That's Syndra and Olaf
and
in the hands of HKC a while ago has been really good. So, if these two champions will fall off in the hands of IVE, that might be a big problem. So it was a good ban coming from UPH.
Yes, and there's also this ban on the Nidalee on control. They've seen the match, even though it did not translate into a victory for the Indonesian team. Still, they've seen how it performs on the Nidalee ban.
Yes.
That explains it. But look at this. UPH, interestingly, they are prioritizing this Zyra. So, this tells a lot about the Indonesian team, that they are more comfortable in their bottom lane, pairing Vinsanity with a more aggressive support. Either if they don't get the Jhin, they still have the Ashe.
So, yes, of
but
course.
But one thing's for sure, they want the Zyra. They definitely want the Zyra.
They want an aggressive support that can just go ahead and zone in. So it will be lessening the pressure coming from Thompson to carry the game. They wanted to bring it on the bot lane.
Yes.
So you have already an aggressive support. And if they're going to lock this Zach, yeah, that would be another big
plus,
edge coming from the Indonesian team.
You want to go for a more aggressive playstyle, but what is this? We are seeing a bar. Do take note that we have the Zyra here. If this gets locked in, the Zyra
will be on the mid lane.
Will Zyra go for the mid lane? Actually, the playstyle of Donson on champions like Anivia, on champions like Zilean, it's quite near, especially with the zone control of the Zyra skit. So we'll see. It's very risky if this bar goes in any other lanes
and
aside
also
from support, but they're gonna go for the rumble. 10 seconds on the clock before everything gets locked in. We'll see.
Oh, but right now they hovered onto that trundle. This might be a top lane and changes that Zach into the rumble. So there's a pause. This will be in the hands of control.
Yep.
Because you already have the support Zyra, not unless you're playing mind games, you're going to put Zyra into the mid lane and Trundle will be the support. But right now, that's not going to happen because you need to respect the Poppy plus the Elise in the hands of IVE.
Yeah.
So you need to respect that by using the grasping roots.
My biggest guess would be a Trundle top lane and Rumble will go
into
the jungle. Interestingly, the playstyle of Nidalee is different compared to the Rumble. But We'll see.
Of course.
Rumble and Zyra has a very nice combo when it comes to the Snorkel turns. If you like cream it up with a equalizer.
Yes, of course.
And of course, you also have the hustle on the front line and the prowess of the tankiness.
Oh my
the
goodness.
But look at this side, ladies
and
gentlemen.
Cassiopeia.
What we'll have is a Cassiopeia getting locked in, paired with an Ezreal. Will this get locked in? You have to take note that Jhin is available.
Oh, yeah.
IVE is more comfortable in locking in this Ezreal. He wants to, you know, just consistently peel away and escape from any engage, any CC, if ever a Grasping Roots manages to connect, if ever a Strangle Swords at the very least. And if ever a Trundle just wants, decided to go hammer.
Yes. You can just go ahead on the back lines and plus the Equalizer. Oh, this is sound good. But that would be a mid lane. That would be Zyra support and the jungle. Rumble.
Zyra support, Trundle top lane. So what will they have in the mid lane?
But it's a bit scary. Like on the hands of UPH, already have the zoning from the plants and of course the strangled horns. You already have also the trap coming from that Yordle snap trap. And you're going to see Aurel and Sol, but hovering on that Anivia, of course you told me, or Shinbu told us that Anivia in the hands of Thompson is really good, more like a control mage or something like that. Not really a long range type, but right now you can see not really in favor of the Jhin, but the firepower coming from it is really exceptional or really good, and they already locked it in.
Yes, so it's an Anivia. Thompson revisiting that
Anivia.
After thing that in China, I'd say I want to commend Thompson's performance. Anivia facing a team as formidable as China, still managed to, you know, be able to put a bit of pressure against China's team. But IVE is going to opt out on taking this Blitzcrank paired with an Ezreal. As far as I know, Nami is still available. Also Karma. But finally, a game without any Karma. We have a Blitzcrank, ladies and gentlemen. Wow.
This is a good pick. It's a good
Zyra,
idea
actually.
Because you have the Zyra and you have that Jhin, which is not totally mobile.
Yeah.
You can just walk in using your overdrive, if I'm not mistaken, and you can just use the sucker puncher or the uppercut.
Yeah.
And then plus the hooks and the silence as well to completely stop both of the bot laners on that one. And then, of course, Ezreal is a bit on mid lane this late game spike because of the Tear of the Goddess. Oh, so it means that Blitzcrank will really compensate on that early mind games that he might drop a hook.
Yeah, well, definitely something has to be done by Blitzcrank here in the early game because we know why Blitzcrank is not that popular, because if he enters the late game, he falls off really bad.
Yes.
Like, it doesn't even translate to any damage. It doesn't even translate into any tank.
Yeah,
that's the problem about his kit. Even though his kit is quite powerful, still it's kind of awkward to really force any hook just because the tank is in the front. But there we have it, ladies and gentlemen, as the members of IVE are grouping up once again. Guys, we will rock you. But guys, 30 seconds before the minions spawn, as we welcome you in the Summoner's Rift. This is the League of Legends International Collegiate Championships Day 2. And Game 5 between UPH versus IVE. Let's go for the champion rundown.
Okay, on the side of UPH, the Indonesian team, that'll be on the top lane. T-Bold on that. Trundle on the jungle, that'll be Control on that. Rumble on the mid lane, that'll be Thompson on his Anivia. On the AD carry marksman, that'll be Vinsanity on that. Jin and supporting, that'll be Wooly on that Zyra.
Meanwhile, on the red side, you have IVE in the top lane. It's gonna be King 2G, 100 Poppy. The jungle is gonna be a Sing 21 with Elise for the mid lane, number 4 on the Cassiopeia. And the bottom blue is gonna be Grenade on that Ezreal ADC. And Baba on that Blitzcrank support, esports, that Garena.ph/stream. Guys, to all of our viewers, again, I want to greet you a happy, happy Saturday evening. And thank you so much for spending it and deciding to spend it with us.
Oh, wow.
But the hook being done here by Baba, all in onto Wooly. Vinsanity decides to go for Grenade. Grenades gets burst. Ironically, now the fourth bullet will connect onto Baba, but no casualty yet. Not even a summoner spell has been burned after that engage. Again, guys, to all of our viewers, be sure to take a screenshot and share the stream link. This is also live on Facebook, so be sure to share it in your own timeline publicly and invite your friends in to watch and accompany us in this amazing evening full of League of Legends action.
Yes, indeed. So LICC started yesterday, so yeah, it was a good start of week. Yep. And so I really want you guys to share this intense match all over the internet, and at least watch it with us. And you can see the aggression coming from Cassiopeia, the mid lane IVE. Really good play coming from that, pushing away Thompson.
Comparing Thompson and Cassiopeia, I think because the flash frost of Anivia has a slower flight time compared to the Instacast, like the big burst or pop of that Noxious Blast. So I think Cassiopeia really has an edge. Thompson's Anivia.
And of course, the mana cost of the Twin Fangs is really, really less. So you can just go, you can take advantage of that one, put up the traits against Anivia, against Thompson.
Yes.
Because Thompson has no, of course, no mana items. You don't have already a tier or even a catalyst. So possibility that Cassiopeia can dish out more damage when it comes to mana consumption.
Yes, plus when you go in, if you're Thompson, when you go in, yes, you can cast Flash Frost on a safe distance. It could connect. But if you go in, if you go in with the Frostbite, the big problem there is that you are in range. And with a follow-up, you're in range to receive a Noxious Blast. You are also in range to be slowed by the Miasma. And all of that, you are in range to receive the Twin Fangs.
Yes. Yes, you do really have a good point on that one. But yeah, considering that Anivia has no totally, you know, any escape mechanism, you can just leave Miasma out for now.
Yeah.
You can just max Noxious Blast or Twin Fangs as early as you can, because you're just fighting an Anivia. The Wallis will be a problem, but right
there
now you can see the first
gentlemen, a bad decision coming in from number 4. Force a flash out as Control closes the gap in. I think that's the end of that engage, but good job there by UPH jungle to burn the flash here in the mid lane against the opponent.
Yes, of course. Of course, Thompson calling out their jungler Control, because you can see the pressure. You can see the trade-up between the Cassiopeia and the Anivia. It was really leaning on the advantage of IVE, number 4. So it was a good call. Control, trying to control the mid lane itself. So yeah, really commending
actually
him on that movement.
I really like the names of the players here, like Control and also Grenade. But look at that. Overdrive gets activated. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, Overdrive. Look at that.
Whoa,
also the
good sidestep.
Really good sidestep. Double sidestep.
Whoa.
To dodge the cocoon, to dodge the rocket grab. Wolfie, ladies and gentlemen.
That was a good play coming from Wolfie. You're just using Zyra, but it was an intense sidestep. And I really commend also Sing21 wasn't able to use the flash.
The legendary moment when you're mitigating the flash.
the prediction.
When you're mitigating the flash with just a right click.
Yes.
Oops, nigga.
Yeah. Respect me, nigga.
What I want to know about you, Alpha. Give it a chance. Are you... Oh, what? Hold on. There's a flash King with just a normal hit. King's going to opt out to give the kill onto T-Bold. As you know, that Control will be in the vicinity. Will be within the vicinity. Interestingly. So that's the decision. You don't want to give any kill for the jungle because the jungle's task is to influence the other lane. But Well, again, going back to my topic earlier, given a chance, would you want to play in the Collegiate League if you were in college?
Yes, of course. Yes, of course. I really love the game, but of course, I'm not as good as mechanically what they are. So I great respects from this guy. All of these guys.
You're not as mechanically
as good when it comes to the game.
Even me, I'm not really as good as them. What's your rank for this season?
Well, I mean, oh god. Why did you ask that one?
Oh my god. Baba, his life in Tagalog going Baba. But, you know, not much. Still, there's the inherent, there's the passing from the Blitzcrank. You really don't want to go all in with anyone
expecting
that has a surprise shield.
Barrier. Yeah. Yeah, but Baba on this Blitzcrank has been matched by Wolfie and Zyra.
Yep.
His grasping roots is on point. The plants really compensating for the aggressiveness of Blitzcrank. So it was really indeed a problem, or it was a good trade-up on the bot lane. Supports really affecting the pacing of the bot lane game.
Yes, but look at this. Thompson position managed to receive that. Cahoon on top of that is the Petrifying Gaze, ladies and gentlemen. But Control is here to take the control. Maybe not as Thompson has become a poisoned egg. Falls into the hands of IVE.
Wow, it was a good max range hit coming from Sync21, and the connection or the synergy follow-up with the Petrifying Gaze was able to lock him down. And of course,
I was wondering about the Petrifying Gaze. Actually, Thompson wasn't really directly looking at Cassiopeia, but still, he gets rooted.
Yeah,
in place.
That's the problem. Like, that's why I stopped for a bit.
Yeah, you want to check?
Why
did Thompson not move?
Yeah, and I'm not really sure if Anivia's eyes was looking at the side, or it's just that the body is facing that one, but his eyes is really looking through the eyes of Cassiopeia. So you need to be open for possibilities like that one.
Legendary,
but Control,
legendary ninja eyes where you're facing the other side, but looking on the other side. Now Equalizer gets used, gets mitigated here by the rappel. The harpoon has been used all on cooldown.
Oh my.
And you can see an overheating control. Take note that number 4 has no ultimate. But he cannot deal that much damage. He goes for the turnaround. Managed to kill Cassiopeia. Gotta go for 2.1. And that's a 2% exchange. A big win here for the Indonesian team UPH.
What happened to that teleport? I think it was stopped by Thibault.
Yep.
So possibility that he uses the Ice Pillar to stop it. And it was a good play coming from Control using those harpoons for a double kill. The cooldown of Harpoon is not that as much, and it has 3 stacks. So you can just go ahead and hit someone continuously.
But look at that. So with an early win, actually, by number 4, he's going to go for more defensive itemization, picking up that Negatron. Actually, it's not really defensive. It's more of the meta talaga.
Yes.
Meta itemization. And you want to go for the Thompson. I wonder what will Thompson pick. He's now recalled. He's gonna pick a Catalyst of Aeons. Gonna wait for the build-up of the Catalyst of Aeons.
Yes, of course.
Wait for the Sapphire and Ruby Crystals.
Well, it will be a good advantage if he's going to finish as early as he can the Catalyst of Aeons, because per cast you can have those health. And of course, every level up, you get those stacking life and mana bars as well. So using that one, you can take advantage of Anivia's damage by having added survivability.
Yes.
But right now you can see also the Negatron's cloak in the hands of number 4. So you get to have some breathing space from the damage coming from the flash.
Oh,
overdrive.
I think that is too much. Even the second bullet, make that the third, the fourth bullet. So it's only 1/4.
Yes.
Yeah.
Kind of failing grade on that.
Yeah.
Accuracy failed.
Yeah. Yeah.
But yeah.
That means 50%.
Going back, of course, checking on that.
There's a flash in from Baba. Managed to grab control from behind. Even with the Strangle Thorns, won't be enough as the engage is on. Healing here from IVE.
I really commend Baba on that play, using the flash just to hit that uppercut rather than using it for a big play or a Mad Life hook. He just secured the kill. And really chaining it into that Blitzcrank hook. But you can see the Ocean Drake, or first Drake of the game, will go down in hands of IVE.
IVE, yes. Yeah. IVE, even UPH. Going for the pokes just to... I don't think it's not even a good effort to
yes, they just they just probably go and, push the bot lane and then goes for a recall. Rather than wasting time on the Dragon Pit, because you can't really do anything about that, knowing that you have the Elise and the Foreman squad in on the side of IVE.
Yes. So,
things have been slowed.
Stoned down, yes, of course. But grenades, positioning. Fort Bullet.
Fort Bullet. He is dancing if all the way. Sing 21 is a big threat for UPH. Know. But you can see overdrive and a force flash. Wow, the accuracy coming from Bob. On the bot lane, you can see the power of accuracy. You have the grasping roots, you have the curtain call, you have the mystic shot and the hooks. So
it's actually more it actually falls into the hands of Baba.
So I think because these guys don't usually study very well trigonometry.
Yeah.
The angular points when you go to college.
One of the actually trigonometry.
Trigo or
Trigo would be very useful in college as well. There are a lot of subjects that utilizes the concepts of trigonometry.
Yes.
Aside from algebra.
Yeah, of course.
Plus, actually, trigonometry improves your logic.
Yes.
Like, and how you think outside about.
That was
Baba
a good hit.
Receiving the first bullet, make that the second bullet, and the fourth bullet. Doesn't even receive the third bullet. I don't know, man.
Oh.
But it's going to be the trap.
Oh, wow.
Going for that with Vinsanity receiving the kill. I think it's a deadly flourish that takes the last hit.
Yes, indeed.
Ladies
and
gentlemen, a good setup
bouncer
by Thibault. Now in the top lane, King 2G, the real G, removes control in the top lane. Now Thompson goes for the chase, even with the crystallize and flash rolls won't connect. And Sing 21 gonna go for the re-engage, but nope, not quite. 4-4 into our scoreboard as kills has occurred on both edges of the map.
Because you're playing with King 2G, more like a Trick 2G name. So I think
King 2G.
One of the inspiration of King to play that out, King 2G.
As I recall, Thompson is actually also like a nice name. It's like a name of a gun.
Yes, it's a name of the gun.
It's a name of a gun.
More like a Tommy gun.
Yeah, so
coming from the mafia's hand. Like, so you're playing with a Tommy gun.
If you have like Uzi,
you have Uzi, you have Thompson.
For ADC, you have grenades.
I lately realized
there's also a player in LICC whose name is Gunner, but that doesn't matter. Baba now go for the mid lane. There's a lot of flash. The guy's burned just because of the Blitzcrank hook.
Baba is really utilizing this Blitzcrank really well. But
Flash cocoon, flash hook, flashes everywhere, all day, every day. Rabel will stop the knockup from the Strangle Thorns, but you have to take note of the plant that grows. Fourth bullet puts in the critical onto Baba. Does Baba has the flash? Baba has his cooldown on flash. Puts the hook in onto Wolfie is gone. Grenade tries to poke away, making sure that he doesn't get tagged by the equalizer, but that will leave Baba gone for good in the top lane. A little bit of a top trade up from Thibault and King 2G, but Flashes and CC, ladies and gentlemen.
Baba, really?
That's all the story.
I was thinking that Baba was going for the hook of Insanity, but it was another good accuracy aiming on that Wolfie. But right now, you can see the battle on the Dragon.
Guys, what is that? Make sure that you dodge that. Nice, Rappel.
Come over up.
He's gonna wait for
up.
You.
Oh!
He receives the third bullet, ladies and gentlemen. Gonna cancel.
Grenade, why?
Gonna cancel. The hurting call.
And the third kill.
Grenade with the chase, ladies and gentlemen. I'm not sure if grenade receives the third bullet. The problem about the Jin's ultimate is when you receive one bullet, it's not really the damage. It's also the slow.
Yes.
It's very likely that if you receive one bullet, the next bullet will hit you because of the slow. It's like a zillion slow.
Well, I think Vinsanity is making up on his accuracy fail a while ago and consistently hitting all of those deadly flourish and curtain call. So giving him a credit on that one. And you can see also Baba forcing onto something once again. His resources are currently up. So Wolfie is a bit on a problem right now, but they don't have a good vision where are they coming from. But you can see here.
The Anivia passive gets melted to become an egg in the top lane. The flame speeder plus double harpoon will connect on the King 2G. Are you the real G? Will you manage to escape, ladies and gentlemen? Control will take no turret hits. Here comes Sing 21 for the re-engage. Any rappel? No, it has been cast already. Cocoon without connecting, not connecting in the bottom lane though. The bottom lane of UPH. Outer turret gets removed, gets destroyed. I think that goes into grenade. That's the first blood turret falling to the hands of IVE.
Yes, the first turret of the game, and that'll be the 400 gold in the hands of IVE. You have the dragon and you have the gold. We're just waiting for the reef arrow to go down, but it was a solo kill coming from King 2G.
Boom, the bold. He's gone.
Wow, that's 3-1 already on that pop.
Look at that. Elise in the back line. Equalizer gets used.
Got the wall.
King 2G managed to stick control. Control will be gone. Once again, King 2G.
king, the real G. More like a kingpin of the Collegiate.
Yeah, 4-1-0 on Big Papi. IVE looking good and looking big as they enter the 15-minute mark, or rather on the 15-minute mark of the game.
I'm not really sure why you stick on the wall, knowing that Kintuji is right there. You can just go ahead in the middle of the turret.
Yeah.
Even though you can see Sync 21, someone can just go ahead and receive the damage from the turret. But I'm not sure. You stay behind the wall.
You know, it's Poppy. It's Poppy. She's the only girl that you don't like when she pins you in the wall.
Oh, wow. That sounded bad.
Look at that. All bullets, all skills, all the CC. He's back against the ice wall. A nice combo from the Jean. Plus the Anivia. Vinsanity takes the kill onto number 4.
Yes, of course. Good play coming from UPH. Once again, the curtain call starting the fight. This Jin, or Vinsanity, has been utilizing it really well compared to the Ezreal.
Yeah.
But yeah, right now, Vinsanity, you just have to change your name. Jin Sanity.
Overdive. Oh, wow. Managed to grab Thompson, ladies and gentlemen. Just like that, gone in the hand here by the IVE support. The synergy of Grenade, or rather the accuracy of Baba on this Blitzcrank is working so well in the favor of IVE.
It sounds bad for T-Bold. He still keep on fighting.
He has the subjugate actually.
Yes, but of course you don't have any turret.
Yes, the chase. There's no turret rather, so it's very dangerous now. The Chomp will be able to mitigate the damage, but he's going to force a flash out. King 2G for the chase like a real G. Get a flash in, puts the hammer shock, and that's a 1v1 kill in the top lane. A prolonged chase. Definitely this top lane of UPH is going south.
Yeah, so what country again, IVE?
Indonesia. IVE? I think.
I just want to confirm.
We will ask later on. What country is IVE? We'll ask the info later on, but UPH, I'm very sure.
Oh, yeah, Hong Kong. I think it's Hong Kong. Because I've seen the TPA skin, it feels like I think it was the Taiwan team. But, yeah, did you know that? Of course, using that TPA, and you're opting for a Triforce, it was the BT days.
I wish we have
That's the attack speed type Ezreal.
I wish we have a Karma. I think it's Karma, the one that's closest to have a Filipino skin.
Because she's more like a Filipina or a Morena type, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was a good one, but
PH
needs to win for
the world. Yeah.
Worlds,
yeah.
Please. But right now,
a heavy fit.
The IP, please win for LICC.
At the very least for LICC. Make it out the group stage.
Yes,
come on, we're
course.
Sending our biggest prayers. We're praying to all of our elder gods here.
Yes, of course, but you can see on the bot lane, the trade up. And still Cassiopeia or number 24, still a big problem.
Number 4, ladies
that
and gentlemen.
One.
Now in the mid lane. So this is a 0-4-1 configuration. We're 4 members, not the mid laner though. He's gonna go for the push in this mid lane. Take note, Baba has activated his overdrive. Gonna receive the slow after it is off duration. So, you know, a little bit of a reset here in the mid lane. This is the big problem. They really can focus the mid lane forward.
Oh, wow.
Oh, wow. Baba with the hook onto Wolfie. Now, critical gets activated. Gonna stop them on their tracks on top of the equalizer.
Mana barrier.
Strangle Thorns won't connect onto anyone. I think that is a premature Strangle Thorns. But Grenade gets defused there by King 2G as a big, big win is done here by apparently by UPH. But still, the chase is on. The clash doesn't end quite yet as they're gonna go for the Poppy. But look at that, the jungler of IVE. As Thompson making his
one
pick.
Flies away.
You have to respect the damage of this Anivia. And in the blink of an eye, we could see that UPH is taking the momentum back, reversing it, takes the bounty. And ladies and gentlemen, oh, the Rip Herald destroys himself.
Okay, so it's time for him to go home already.
But I think that's an unofficial 4-0 exchange. They might go for an unofficial ace because number 4 has been aggressive. Doesn't take into account the passive of the Anivia. Will Thompson manage to escape? No, he won't. And that concludes that engage in a 2-4 exchange. What a back and forth team fight.
Yes, it was a good play coming from number 4, hitting the petrifying gaze to stop or to stall him. Oh, wow! The snipe from Grenade. Really good on that one.
Yeah.
Sniping away T-Bold.
11-14. Still, you have to take note that IVE, the team from Hong Kong, has a 5K gold lead. That explains a 5K gold deficit against the Indonesian team UPH. And take note, IVE is going to plan to pull off a Baron power play Apple taking this one. I don't think, I really doubt this can be stolen by any genie, but a deadly flourish. And there you have it, guys.
Of course.
What can UPH do to bounce back?
Well, UPH can do is they can take advantage of this Anivia. I mean, Thompson is really good at this Anivia. You just have to stay, be stable. T-Bolt has been not really good on his place because,
yes,
because he keeps on fighting King 2G. He needs to respect the fighting potential of a Poppy. Like, it's already a 6-2 Poppy. In this, you keep on overextending, trying to push the lane. You ain't the king.
I thought he's gonna go for it and make that hook.
Oh, walls.
And just going for that minion reference, ladies and gentlemen, as the lead is on, and they're gonna go for a siege with one minion. Equalizer gets casted. Even the curtain call is not used in an optimal manner. Now IVE can take this turret.
Yes, it's really, they're going to take it easily because they have the Baron buff and the proto belt has been used by the cocoon. Yes, it was indeed catch up and
Reed
from the shot barrage. And the Shangle Torrent has been used as well. Resources down. Petrifying Gaze is down as well.
Petrifying
catching
Gaze.
Out the Flash Frost. Thompson was able to secure the kill.
Petrifying Gaze misses.
Yes.
What is that? A big misplay coming in.
Well, I'm not really sure.
Four.
That's not a good place to fight. It is a wide place. And
it's
it was closer to the inner turret. So why you didn't respect?
Yes, it's forcing too much. Guys, to all of our viewers, especially to the Filipino viewers, because this broadcast is done by Garena Esports Philippines, please do take note that UPH is the school
Indonesian.
From Indonesia. It's an Indonesian team.
Let's make it clear, guys.
It's not the Philippine team. Our Philippine team school, an abbreviation is TIP, Technological Institute of the Philippines.
Yeah, so
UPH, UPH here in the Philippines is University of Perpetual Health.
But it's not.
It's not, guys. It's different. It's Indonesian.
Respect them. Come on.
Yes, guys. So to our viewers in the chat, if you're listening, please.
big shout out to you guys
who are
watching.
I know you are very excited to witness.
But this is that will be the game six.
After this.
So you guys need to watch this, and then after this you get to watch the TIP. Okay,
yes.
Let's cheer for them.
Yes, let's give our support. They need to rack up points as much as possible. 12-14.
Of course, a big shout out to Coach Artek and the gag.
Yes, 12-14, ladies and gentlemen. As we enter the 24-minute mark of this game, UPH versus IVE. If you look into the itemizations, what are your insights? Double QSS. Hands of IVE.
Yeah, they really greatly respecting that Strangle Torch and the Flash Frost as well. But
wow.
You can see the top lane control.
Let's see if the King 2G 6-2-0 Poppy, can he survive a 2v1? Make that
opened.
A 2v1 plus the four bullets. Make that three bullets of the curtain call. I think that is enough. One bullet managed to miss, but in the bottom lane, his members, his allies, tries to force things too much in the bottom lane. Managed to snag away Wolfie.
That sounds bad. You keep on pushing the kills from King 2G. Yes, he has a bounty. But the second dragon, the third dragon, that'll be the Cloud Drake. That will help them from the rotation.
Equalizer! Number four forces to flash out on top of that equalizer. Could have been good, but look at the burst coming in from IVE. They managed to also pop control.
They need to, Thompson really needs to use the wall and the Flash Frost really well to win on this fight. To protect this bot lane, but I think IVE is going to stop this one and probably focus on
Sync 21 in bad position, gets isolated by the Crystallizer. Good job there, buddy Thompson.
I'm not really sure. Coming from Sync 21, you could have been flash over the wall rather than on site.
Sync
21.
21 dies.
Oh, wow.
Day after day.
Time after time.
I think my lyrics is off.
Yeah, your lyrics is off.
I'm sorry,
but
guys.
It was a good joke, though.
I just keep on thinking about the gun reference of Thompson.
21 guns.
Yes. Plus, you know,
from the Green Day.
Yes. So, there's actually a supplement that he can over the team's name. If you carefully observe, there's a buff if you unlock that.
Wow, achievement unlocked.
So, back into the game. Right now, the situation is an 8K gold deficit against the Indonesian team UPH. But it will be offset if the Bold managed to destroy, and I think he will, this outer bottom lane turret.
Yeah, going back on the names of the players, the most interesting that I wanted to know will be Baba.
Baba.
Why? Why Baba?
Actually, Baba is like it's like a courtesy name for Grandma.
Oh,
for Baba.
Well, yeah, but I think it is something special when it comes to Indonesian or Hong Kong side.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's quite interesting to see this, those kind of names manifesting. Like, because usually when you get to play League of Legends, you get to use different language.
Yes.
And right now, they are using their own language. It's really good.
Do take note, in the 26-minute mark, our next Drake would be Cloud.
Wow.
If IVE managed to take that next Cloud Drake,
they can just take the, out their boots.
They have a triple Cloud Drake. And one champion that you would want to observe with a triple Cloud Drake would be Baba, the Blitzcrank, as he goes for the chase, and also Cassiopeia. Whenever he procs, she actually benefits on the idea that she could have one extra item.
Yes.
Because she doesn't have to wear boots.
And plus the power of the Cloud Drake, it's a possibility that she can just go ahead and snake away, not using the ghost, just sidestepping all of those kill shots coming from UPH.
Yes.
But yeah, Blitzcrank or Baba can really take advantage of
this one. Is that a flash by Wooly? Wow. Managed to connect someone with the Grasping Roots, follow up with the Strangle Zones. Sing21, Guns Thompson though, getting so low as he received a lot of damage. Coming in from grenades, Gertz bursted. That is the mid lane here by UPH. Now, they're gonna go for the push. They're gonna close the gap in this top lane inner turret. Baba will flash in. Baba won't get anything, but grenade will connect one Q onto control. But it's just objectives after objectives and the pressure. The pressure, the game of pressure and three shot is being won here. But the Hong Kong team, IVE.
The pacifying gaze has been used to the plants.
Oh.
So it wasn't able to hit anyone. And the burn flash coming from Baba burned the flash of Thompson. So if you're going to have the best defying glaze as early as you can use it against Thompson. Take down Thompson. Take the whole game. Because the power of insanity is not yet totally manifesting. Like, you can see it on the curtain call, but on close range, or the foot, or the first bullet, has been not being utilized mostly.
The sidestep by Wolfie! I think Wolfie is, you know, already tired of getting
caught out.
Getting hooked by Baba time and time again.
And the Baron is live.
I could feel you, man.
Bad,
I mean, the Blitzcrank pick as well is.
It's a mind
specifically,
game.
It is specifically pick against the Zyra.
Yeah.
Because in the bottom lane, aggressive bottom lane, then
and
let's pick someone. Let's grab someone.
It's kind of psychologically will hurt you because if he keeps on landing those hooks, you just gone on tilt and just let go of everything.
You just want to just get away from the range of the Blitzcrank.
Yeah, that's like what Aika said.
Gonna go for the second Baron, though. Of this game.
Yes, the curtain call down.
We're looking for the engage. Equalizer
trying to take it down, but they are burning it. And of course, we have Sing21 to secure that on the true damage.
And even Baba gets punished by the equalizer, but they did not decide for the re-engage. So that is another siege to be done with a Baron enhanced minion and Baron enhanced team. They're gonna collapse out with this inner mid lane turret.
And this sounds bad because they have 30 seconds. You're going to have the last dragon for the elementals, and next will be the elder, and they are moving it all up. So possibility that UPH is not going to contest this one. This might be a vision game or a bait play coming from IVE. Use Baba just to, you know, take out someone, and you can see it right now moving in, and this might be a possible hook. And no, they wanted to take the game surely, so slowly by just going back, take advantage of what we have, and just, you know, stole the Cloud Drake. Because, if on the player's perspective, Cloud Drake is not as big as you want, or not an Infernal Ocean.
Yep.
So
but
you
if
can
it's
just
triple
let go of that one.
But it's triple
Cloud Drake. So we need to get this one.
It is definitely game-changing, especially if you want to seal the deal with that mobility of yours. You could easily translate lanes between lanes.
It's because that they recall despite that everyone's up on the side of UPH. So I was thinking that, come on guys, let's go back. Let's go over the Cloud Drake. But they were able to catch up, and knowing that they have no vision, UPH has no vision, they are not brave enough to dive in and try to secure the Cloud Drake.
Yes.
So it was a good play coming from IVE, taking the itemizations as early as they can before taking out the Cloud Drake.
UPH is actually giving away a few number of objectives, especially the Baron, the Vision,
and they are keep on
and also the Drake.
Yeah, they are outrated by IVE after what happened when Kim2G died. This were you know, the second Cloud Drake, so still bad for them. And
wow, so Baba style would be to predict the sidestep.
Yes. And it was on the other side. Yeah. It was blind. The ward has been blinded because of the oracles. When, so yeah, you can't really predict that much.
17, ladies and gentlemen. And now it's just Baba aiming to catch someone.
And it's a good idea that you have Miasma on top of some, I mean, below of someone, and then you can use the hook. So no one can flash. No one can take away.
Oh! You're gonna skill in front of a Blitzcrank.
Signing the death contact.
Yeah, he's not gonna fall back against you. He's gonna bring a Blitzcrank hook in your face. And with a minus one, with control gone, this bottom lane will also fall out of control. The bottom lane inhibitor turret will be destroyed. They're gonna knock on this bottom lane inhibitor.
Okay, so you need to respect, of course, Thompson and that Anivia. He is still around, but the top lane is Diebold and Kim2G. The
kingpin. Oh! Managed to receive!
Oh,
my
goodness.
Doesn't even respect the health and the passive. The damage from Grenade and number four. I think this could be the game as four members are in the underworld in the side of UPH. Ladies and gentlemen, IVE of Hong Kong. They are knocking on the second Nexus turret, ladies and gentlemen, with a hook. Baba is just on point. Crazy, crazy Baba. Blitzcrank, ladies and gentlemen. That's the Nexus destroyed. And a big win. Rather, a big and a clear, clear win from IVE by IVE of Hong Kong.
Wow, it was a good play coming in from IVE. But of course, before closing this one, I have a joke.
Oh.
Okay, knock, knock.
Who's there?
Baba Blitzcrank.
Baba Blitzcrank who?
Baba Blitzcrank, have you ever hooked? Yes, sir. Yes, sir. He feels cool.
Wow.
And so great, guys. So great. So good. So great.
What happened in your last games in solo queue?
I don't know, man.
That you...
I think it's the power of Bacchus. When you really drink that energy drink, it powers you up until your jokes.
I thought you just tilt in real life because of the running assassins in the 6.22 patch.
The confidence from Baba when you hook, and then Cassiopeia is going to put the Miasma on where Blitzcrank is. That's the confidence of his team as well, believing that he's going to take away someone.
I'd still go for the scene. 21 guns. Anyway, you know, we're just making jokes for our LICC players. I know a lot of you are familiar with your respective LICC collegiate players for your respective leagues. But you know what we want here is for you to get closer, get up close and personal with our LICC players, with our pros. You know, so for you to be inspired, for you to be involved with the league. That's a really nice game, and for this LICC, we will still not finish in bringing you amazing League of Legends action. So, guys, we're gonna proceed to our next game.
TIP versus HKC, guys.
Team Philippines, ladies and gentlemen, brace yourselves. Brace yourselves for our Filipino viewers. We have been your shoutcasters for this match. I am Shinbu with a 1-4-1, and I am with Alpha, ladies and gentlemen. LOL International Collegiate Championships 2016. We'll be right back for Game 6. Hold it right there.